Change is good. And speaking of change with day one and all this stuff, we're having a brownout over here. The lights keep flickering. How is thank you doing? Thank you, Skateboards. That's amazing, dude.
It's a great name, by the way.
I know.
Thanks, man. No one's really asked me that. thank you is doing great. It's so cool, man. It's so cool just to be the guy to, make the moves and make the change and really see the growth in it and starting it from the bottom was cool because you get to see it grow.
Sure. Yeah. And you're no stranger to business. I mean, Grizzly, obviously very successful and everything. And then, but I feel like board companies is a totally different beast than clothing, and grip tape. It's like, these are skateboards, and graphics, and you got to keep constantly, updating and stuff.
Dude, it's all a beast. They're all beasts, man. Sure. Like business is a beast for sure. There's no easy way out.
Right.
Or easy way in,
Totally. So,
yeah, it's Grizzly is a beast. And it's hard to control the beast for sure. It's grown. It's it's became so much bigger than I ever thought something could be,
Right.
It's different, it's a different type of brand, I think, than thank you is.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you is it's a small brand. It's a small board brand,
We heard you're screening your boards yourself. Heat transferring your boards yourself.
Yeah. Currently I'm doing all production for all of them.
That's amazing.
That's so sick.
We heard you're heat transferring the boards and shrink wrap them all by yourself.
Yeah, it's the full process, man. And not only that, it's I gotta actually make sure that I'm getting all the material too.
Yeah.
Right.
I gotta get the blanks. I gotta get the heat transfers. I gotta put in the POs. Even after the board is finished, shrink wrapped, I gotta put it into the inventory, and once the boards are sold, then I gotta be the AP guy.
You're a one man band.
But yeah, we all skate and everything, but learning it from the start, because people could always hire people to get into a certain position or screen the boards or do this or do that, but doing it yourself, you're learning literally the whole process.
Well, I feel from an outsider's perspective, they think thank you might be this giant thing.
Sure.
But they don't know that Torey's out there skating every goddamn day and then fucking putting the heat transfers on the boards, shrink wrapping them, putting them on the shelves, making sure they're all in the inventory and everything else.
A lot of work.
Labor, it's a lot of work. Yeah,
labor of love.
Yeah.
Labor of love.
I don't think anyone knows, man. I haven't really put it out there to market it that all boards are made by me.
Yeah. Right. You did something though with iDabble. Didn't you do a little iDabble thing? Was that on iDabble? Where did I see something? You were screening that, you were doing the whole board, you were showing the process. What was that? Was that
on iDabble? I posted a silly video on my YouTube. I'll probably take down because it's my YouTube channel. The last two videos I put on were just too corny,
It's YouTube, bro.
You're filming yourself and
the thing with YouTube though, you need to be consistent.
Yeah.
Great. Yeah, you gotta be consistent, but I don't know, man. I have a hard time trying to make my own videos.
Right.
Yeah, it's difficult.
I was trying to get into YouTube. I was kept hearing YouTube people are making it on YouTube. And I was third time just thinking about it, all right, I'm going to give this a shot. So I filmed an unboxing video.
Yes. It's not going to happen overnight, though.
I didn't even know what was in the box or nothing. And I just at home and I told my wife, I was hey, watch this. Check this out. Set up my phone on my coffee table in a shoe for the tripod. And then I just did the unboxing video. I thought it was hilarious.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It's just it's it's just, I don't know. It's kind of dumb.
No, but here's the thing though. You got to realize that, like,
don't be scared to put yourself out there.
Yeah, it may be dumb to you. Yeah. It's not dumb to the kids who are watching it. You know, you're not doing an unboxing video for, like, you know, myself or Kelly or Paul Rodriguez to watch, right? You're doing, like, Paul Rodriguez.
The fans.
Yeah, the fans. So, like,
but dude, that's the thing. Have you seen, like, the unboxing videos out there?
Yeah.
They're on the next level unboxing videos. It's not like super low budge. Like, mine's super low budge and ghetto.
Yeah, but
like,
those people also put in the work to get to where they're at.
Yeah.
Like, where they're getting like PS5 sent to them and then they're unboxing.
Sure.
And they started where you are. Yeah. They started right where
you're at ground zero.
Yeah, you're ground zero, dude. Yeah. You got to start somewhere.
I thought it out. I tried it, and you know, even with Instagram, it's kind of the same. It's like, you know, trying to film like Instagram clips and like being consistent with it. And you know, like, I like to interact on Instagram, but like to like film things for posts, it's like, it's pulling teeth sometimes to go out and do that, you know.
One thing I'd like to watch from you would be like, maybe like, because you've done some pretty fucked up shit on a skateboard, like post like all those battles that you've had and then like talk about it, the story about it.
Wow.
Hell, you know? Yeah,
you can like talk about how long it took you to backtail that one ledge that went for fucking ever.
Yeah, or you can talk about it right here actually.
Yeah, how long did that take?
Yeah.
then I gotta get all the footage from the filmer.
Well, that's when you need to have a dude you can count on.
I gotta make an edit, and then I gotta like do a voiceover for it.
Yeah, no, it is a process.
I can't do it once and be like, oh, okay, cool, I did it. Then I gotta do another one.
Gotta do, yeah.
You know, which I'll get to that, man. But
partner up with your camera operator and
I'm not hating on Instagram posts or YouTube posts, but
no, like, we hear you.
Hey, get Twan to work finally. You know what I'm saying? Make him do some shit. I'm just kidding.
That's the thing. We're like doing like the hardest shit to do, and that's going out in the streets and like stacking clips.
Right. Yep.
How did Thank You come about? Like, what made you decide to start a board brand?
Well, it was a long process, man. You know, like, and it didn't always start as Thank You. You know, it was like a solid, like, it was 2 years in the making.
Really?
It really just all started with like, I had a vision to do something new, like something of my own, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because doing a board brand, once again, Grizzly's mine, but like, doing a board brand, like, that is skateboarding, you know?
Yeah.
And like, riding for Plan B, like, it's so amazing. Like, I think 7 to 8 years I was on the team.
Damn.
And dude, it was so good. It was so rad, and like, it was family. And I had that vision where I was like, well, you know, like, I want to do something that's mine, though. You know, I want to create something that is, you know, I've created, and you know, I don't skate for someone else's creation, which I was always honored to be a part of that fam, you know, continue to just feel great that, you know, that time and that era is always going to be a part of me. But I really just kind of was willing to take the risk to see if I could see through my vision. And I'd never know unless I tried.
Yeah. Yep. I'd imagine you probably saw a lot of success with Grizzly and like, all right, I can do this now.
Grizzly is 10 years this year.
Wow.
Congratulations, dude.
That's congrats, awesome. Bro.
Which, man, dude, like, I tell you, it's hard to make it that long, dude.
Fuck yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's been 4 years for the Nine Club and I'm exhausted.
But here's the difference with Grizzly, you know, like, I've always been the face of Grizzly. You know, I started it when I was a little kid, like 11, 12 years old. And like, it was always something that was a part of me, you know? And, you know, you could look at Grizzly like Grizzly is me. And then once it started as a company and it grew and we did so many rad things, I can't say that like I was doing all those things. You know, like,
the team, yeah.
We had a team. My partners, you know, and starting a business without even knowing a thing about business and just organic skateboard experience and natural, you know, marketing skills from just branding myself as a skateboarder, you know, that's what I continued to do. So like, you know, I would pick up things here and there and I would meet people here and there, but I didn't run the business.
Right.
And even now, like Grizzly's a beast, man. Like, I couldn't run that company. It's huge.
Yeah.
But with Thank You, you know, I did start it off out of Grizzly. Mm. I did license it to Grizzly. And then after some time, and I always knew this from the beginning too, after some time that I wanted to go on my own.
Right.
And I felt that it's been like a year now. We're coming up on a whole year. The brand's launched almost in November. It'll be 2 years.
Okay.
But we're coming up on a year where I took Thank You on its own, and that was like me stepping up to take on the responsibility to run the company myself.
Right.
No employees. You know, no one there to do it for me. And that was, that was something I didn't really know at all what I was getting myself into. maybe I can do this, you know?
What made you come up with that decision to like, just take it on your own? Was it because it was like too many cooks in the kitchen if you had it at Grizzly, or?
I just wanted to do it how I would do it.
Yeah.
And I felt like I've never done that before. I've never owned and ran a business, you know?
Kind of an experience and a challenge.
Yeah.
Dude, it was totally something that I was doing to challenge myself.
Mm-hmm.
I thought about it long and hard. And I even asked some of my mentors what they thought about it and you know, my best friends. And they thought I was crazy, dude. They told me I couldn't do that. And they're like, well, how are you going to skate?
Yeah.
Still do that. You're not going to skate anymore. And I was like, oh, no. I mapped it out where I was like, I just got to do this. I got to do this. I got to do this. And then once I went for it, like there was like a shift. There was like, okay, you know, it's an idea to like, I'm following through now and I am doing this. There's no turning back.
Right. So,
and that's where it was like, I didn't know a damn thing, dude. I didn't know a damn thing. I learned everything myself. I had to take the time to learn how everything was done. I didn't know how to write a PO. I don't even know what a PO meant.
Purchase order?
Purchase order, you know? So like, that's one of the easiest things I have to do now is write POs.
Right. You know? Yeah. Like,
but even just trying to find the PO template, I was just like,
I love that, dude.
I was like, for one, I was like, what the hell is Excel?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay, it's the program to make POs. I was like, I can't find the template for the damn PO in Excel.
Yeah.
So I'm like, getting on the phone like, hey, John, like, how do I find the PO template? Like, can you send me one? Like, he's like, dude, just Google.
You can learn anything on Google.
I know.
And then, dude, it's just like, so, you know, just learning about like business makes you learn about life too, because you know, what I learned is like, everything's going to be hard the first time you do it. Anything's going to be hard the first time you
It'll
do
be
it.
Easier. And, yeah.
Easier and easier and easier to then where it's like, you know, you know how to do it. Mm-hmm. And
that's valuable.
Totally.
There's nothing cooler than like having the experience to know how to do shit.
And that's what I love. And that's why I think that, you know, showing people or telling people about like, Thank You and you doing it yourself and everything, it puts a whole new perspective on that company. And it makes people and skateboarders like rally around you even more, you know, that you just didn't be like, okay, cool. Hey, we're going to do a company. You guys take care of this. You guys take care of that. I'll see you guys later. I'll check in. Like, no, you're 100% doing it yourself. Yeah. And skateboarders, dude, they love that.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong though. If you can do something and have everyone do it for you.
And
check in. Like, it is cool, but like, shit ain't gonna get done.
Okay. Yeah. Right.
Ain't gonna get done the way you want it. Gotta pay dudes to do it.
Yeah.
What's the old saying? If you want something done right, do it yourself.
Yep.
There
you
go. Yeah. No, I just think that there's a story there, you know, and people love stories and they can get behind it and rally around you. You know, I think it's rad to be transparent with people, you know, especially in skateboarding.
You look at Mike V, what he does with Street Brand. I mean,
Street Plant.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
You know,
Mike V's in his garage.
Yeah.
They get the boards. They know where it's coming from.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And when Mike V signs it and puts with love.
Mike V's putting it in a box for you and putting a label on it and saying you got a box from Mike Vallely.
Yeah.
Like, and that's insane.
And now you're getting it from Torey.
Yeah.
It's cool too. Like doing like a skateboard company. Like, for one, it's like I had to learn everything about how to run a business, right? Mm. And like, it's me running a business, okay? So I don't know how many people like hear that and they take that serious or what they think about it, but I thought the same thing. Like, hey, it's like I'm running a business, but like it's me running a business. Like, kind of crazy. So like, I have to do everything right. I cannot fuck up. So I do everything very carefully. I take tons of precaution and I make sure that everything is done right.
Yeah, your name's attached to it.
Because too, it's like, dude, I got to manage the finances too.
Yeah.
And dude, that's something that you have to plan and look so far ahead to do shit where like you can run your company into the ground easy and not even know it because what you're doing now, it's going to affect you 3, 4, 5 months down the line.
Mm-hmm.
How many employees do you have? Just you and your brother?
Me, and then I brought my brother on right before COVID started. Okay. So this was like end of January. Mm-hmm. I hired my brother full time to do domestic sales.
Rad.
Oh wow.
Yeah, and the reason why I hired him was because, for one, like, I've always been impressed by my brother's work ethic. He's like actually like a next level dude. And it's cool because it's like he worked at Skate Lab since he was 15. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we obviously grew up skating there. But, you know, he worked there for 17 or 18 years.
Wow.
And like for a long ass time, I didn't even realize. I was like, yeah, like my brother's like involved in the game, the same game that I'm in. And like, I didn't even really realize it because it's like what he did for the Skate Lab was like, I mean, he managed the skate park, which was one thing. And like, you know, obviously it's like you check people in, you sweep up, you clean the toilets, mm-hmm. you kick people out. But he was the buyer for the shop. So it's like, he's dealing with like, some of my heroes, you know what I mean? Like, you know, like all the big companies, like he knows all the guys there and like, you know, they're he's doing business with them. So
he knows the sales probably.
Well, that's the thing. He gained so much knowledge on the other side of things, mm-hmm. being a buyer, that he'd never done sales before. But your top sales guys, like now, they were all buyers at one point, and totally. You know, they understand the other side of the game. So so he took to it real fast, man. He was so good at it, and you know, the reason why I hired him was because I was doing sales.
How was that?
That takes a lot of your time.
I did everything, dude. Every single position of a business as one dude. Keep the overhead low, right?
Yeah, of course.
What's it like for Torey Pudwill, a professional skateboarder, to call up a shop in the Midwest and be like, hey, can I talk to your buyer? Like, and then they're like, yeah, this is Torey Pudwill. And they're probably like, what the fuck? Of course we'll buy your boards.
Right, yeah. It's all a little advantage.
Or they could be like, oh my God, I feel bad for this dude. He's like, he's a legit pro skateboarder. He's trying to sell my skateboards right now.
No, man. That's the difference between me and other dudes. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I feel like what I'm doing or everything I did, like, That's how it should be, dude. Like mm-hmm. a real skateboard company. You know what I mean? Skater owned, skater ran, skater operated.
It's awesome. Like,
there's nothing wrong with that.
Hell oh, no.
There's nothing wrong with any other brand that makes, you know, multi-millions a year.
Yep.
Whole staffs and warehouses either. But that's exactly what the shop dude asked me. Mm-hmm. He's like, what's it like to like phone in a shop?
Yeah.
You know, I'm just like,
and then get to hear the truth.
I was like, dude, to tell you the truth, you're the first one I've called. I was really nervous to call. And thanks for being so cool about this.
Did you ever think about like using an alias?
Nah.
This is Tom from Thank You Skateboards. Yeah.
I thought about using an alias for like when I need to like be the dickhead when I'm collecting checks.
Right. Send it from Tom at Thank You.
Yeah. Tom, I think he's pissed.
Yeah.
Dude, so you know, I don't know how like serious dudes would take it, but like, yeah, I mean, dude, I went all in, you know. That's the amazing thing is like I started with doing all of international sales.
Oh, wow. So,
like dealing with like right now I think I deal with 32 different distributors.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, all across the world. And you know, that for me was, I think, something that I was really willing to take on because I wanted to build the relationship with these guys, mm-hmm. you know, and there's thousands of shops still, so many skate shops. Yeah. Like everyone's got to support their local skate shop, support skate shops that aren't even local, you know, because the skate shops literally like that's part of the heart and soul of skateboarding, man. Like they're here to support skateboarding.
Mm.
We always got to be true to them.
True.
But as far as, you know, the distributors go, it's like, you know, these guys are the guys that are handling full countries.
Yeah.
So I wanted to just build the relationship with them, get to know them, even like when they're in town,
yeah.
they'll hit me up to meet with them in person.
Yeah.
Which is like, it's so interesting to me. It's like what do these dudes even realize? Like, I'm like, not the dude to like meet with not the normal meeting, you know, like
you're like, I'll be at this school on Saturday, come hang out.
I remember my Swiss distributor hit me up, and you know, they usually plan it out ahead of time, and yeah, I told them I'd meet up. I got the coffee shop near my house, so for me that's like, because they always ask like, can we meet at your office?
Oh, okay.
And I don't have an office. Right. Unless you want to come into my house and, you know, that's, I work from home.
Sure.
Legitimately in-house. Right. But I mixed up the dates for this meeting completely forgot about it. I thought it was like 2 days after or something. You know, you mix up the 24th and 26th, you think they're the same thing. So the like 24th came, and I'm getting a knock on my door.
Oh.
And this was at like 8:30 in the morning. And then it's a dude and a chick, and I'm looking like, you know, I have like my closet in my house, which has like my monitor with all my camera angles.
Oh, gotcha.
I'm looking on the camera. I'm like, like answer this 8:30 in the morning. They're probably some Jehovah Witnesses.
Yeah, like who is this?
You know, and I give my time to these people, but not 8:30 in the morning. I just stare at them in the cameras, watch them for a bit. They knock again, and you know, eventually they leave. So I'm like, all right, cool, no worries. Go back to sleep, and then by the time it's like 10:30, 11, I get a call, and I was like, the hell is this number calling me, dude? I'll answer a number unless I got it saved in my phone book. You know, leave a message.
Right.
+3432.
No, so it calls me like 2-3 times, and then like I didn't realize they left a message, and it was the distributor from Switzerland. And I was like, oh man. I called them right away, and I was like, hey man, just getting up right now. What time is that meeting at? Oh, I'll be at the coffee spot in 5 minutes. Oh my God. So I went over there, I met with them, and we, you know, obviously talked business for 2 hours.
Yeah.
Did you tell him that you eventually that you had fully just watched him the whole time?
They just found out.
Well, the thing that was crazy, dude, is like I didn't expect him to come to my house. It's like how does the distributor know where I live?
Right, right.
Oh wow. You never gave me your address.
It could have been on some little paperwork or something. That's you never know.
Address. That's the address of the company.
Oh. Yeah.
So he came, literally was coming.
You might want to change that.
Literally was coming to meet me in my office.
Right.
You know?
He was probably confused as hell, too. He's probably like, I'm supposed to go to an office, but this is a nice house. I don't know what that. Maybe just ring the doorbell and see.
I wasn't expecting you to come to my house, but, you know, I get it. And, you know, it's cool. It's really cool meeting with these guys, man. It's cool, like, that they give me the time to take me serious, to talk about the company. Mm-hmm. And for me to take the time to have those meetings, it helps me learn so much.
Oh.
So much more about how business is done, how other people do, you know, business in other places.
Yes.
And they believe in you and your product.
Shit, right. You
and
know?
They've been probably buying your board for the past 25 years too, you know? That's amazing.
Yeah. I think people will always take you serious because you've been a professional skateboarder for so long.
Yeah.
You know, they've been watching you and they're like, cool, I want to work with Torey.
Well, I'm just like, man, I can't wait to get the video part out, dude. I want to stoke all these people out, you know, let them know. It's like, dude, this is what I'm doing, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm answering your email, your call. I'm going to your meeting. I'm sending out your orders. I'm taking all your requests. But at the same time,
in the streets,
check out the video part. Right. This is the current, you know. This is me continuing, like, you know, my job.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like, you know, I'm at the top of my game.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel great about it. And that's why, you know, for me, I put in 100 into everything I do. And, you know, it's fun with the company, and with skating, it's really tough because I've filmed 11 video parts. I've been skating for 24 years. I've done all the back tails that I can, and the ledge. I don't know how higher of a ledge I can skate, but I'm continuing to challenge myself in all those ways.
Yeah,
the plant base will help.
Yes,
but none of it's going to get easier. You know,
sure.